And it's going to be Soon, though. Quickly picks him up. Ash Tracer Soon just being such a nuisance in the side of Fnatic. You see he's going to lay down that Pulse Bomb. He's able to get one player with it. How is he still alive?
Soon is a god on Tracer.
Is that a pro Tracer? It sure is. What's going on, everybody? It's Frito here for your Overwatch, and today we're going to be breaking down some gameplay from the most recent LAN event, DreamHack Winter, where not only did Misfits take the championship, but they did so in style. At an event where just about every team was running 3 and 4 tanks, Misfits bucked the trend and enabled their skilled roster to flourish, playing mostly in a 3 DPS setup with a large amount of the heavy lifting done by Soon on Tracer. In this video, we're gonna break down specifically what does Soon do to make his Tracer and his team so effective. Throughout the event, the biggest running theme of Soon's playstyle is to find himself positioned in the blind spot of the enemy. You can't hit what you can't see. Here the enemy Soldier 76 even has attack visor up, but by constantly either staying behind his tank or behind his enemy, he's never in a position to take any damage. Soon plays with a quick sense of urgency, so when he sees an opportunity to burst in on the enemy Soldier 76, he gets in extreme close range where Tracer is lethal, and in a blink of an eye, he's back out again. He gets in the blind spot of the Roadhog, and as soon as the Hog looks to face him, to the point where he could take some damage, he recalls back to get right back in the fight and finishes off the Zen. Goes back at the Roadhog, but allows himself to be at a separate angle from his teammate Zarya on the other side of him. This shows some crucial positioning choices for not only just Tracer, but the Misfits team comp in general. Because especially when they're in their triple DPS lineup, it's important for them to take as many different angles as possible, so that when the enemy turns to fight one of them, the other one has an opportunity to fire at an unaware target. As they make their push around the corner, Misfits set up what I'm gonna call their mullet playstyle. Widowmaker business in the front, Tracer party in the back. Regardless of which fight the enemy decides to go into, one of the two options is gonna tear them apart. And generally speaking, seeing as Widowmaker is the more lethal of the two, they have to respect her angle even more so most of the time, allowing for Soon on his Tracer to do the dirty work in the back end. Also keep in mind the restraint that Soon has on his movement. Once he gets himself positioned where he wants to be, there's no real reason to blink around unnecessarily. Only when the enemy team looks at him and he needs to dodge, or to get back into the positioning he wants to be in. Here's an exact replica of the same push against Fnatic this time, and here we can marvel at Soon's ability to use blink while shooting to forcibly close the distance in order to increase his damage on a target that's running away. He does this twice as Cool Matt runs away on Soldier, and due to Tracer's damage drop-off, if he wasn't able to land those forward blinks while aiming, there's no way he would have done enough damage in order to finish off the kill before he got away. Here, Soon's playing Tracer on defense and Fnatic are making their way up to push the first checkpoint. He jumps down to harass, and the entirety of Fnatic respond and try to pounce him, but with his quick blinks, they can't touch him, and he pretty much okey-dokes them all the way into the corner. Now with a decision to make, Fnatic decide to at least take the high ground rather than trying to fight their way back out of the server room. This is an interesting role reversal, and now it looks like the attacking team is on defense. Here, Fnatic are trying to find a pickoff from range, but Misfits is playing too spread out to give them an easy opening, until, of course, Zebulsai tries to close the distance in order to confirm the kill on the Zenyatta, but gets fragged himself. However, likely based upon the good communication between the team, Soon knows that the Zen is low and jumps at the opportunity to finish him off. Confirms the kill on the Soldier as well, injures the Lucio, sticks the Pulse Bomb to the Reinhardt's face, and then finishes off everybody. Soon indeed is a god. Now one of the most important matchups that Soon's Tracer showed us at DreamHack Winter was his ability to absolutely style on enemy Roadhogs. In the triple tank composition, Roadhog is the key to giving the team a damage output, because without it, the rest of the tanks don't do enough damage to win team fights by themselves. After Buds pulls in Nevix, Soon knows he has a 6-second timer before the next enemy Roadhog hook, but a well-placed right-click can end his life as well, so he dances around Buds to expend some of his ammo and makes him literally spin in circles. Whether Soon gets that kill or not, tying up so much of the Roadhog's time allows for the rest of his team to have a pretty good fight against the other tanks who can't do as much damage. But the way he avoids death is by reading the animation of where Roadhog is looking. At any time, he can feel himself into the kill zone dead ahead of the Roadhog. He blinks away to try to get into the Roadhog's blind spot. Soon only shoots a few times in the footsie battle, because it's far more important to dodge the damage from the insta-kill Roadhog than it is to dive for the kill right away. Until, of course, he catches him at a weird angle with a wall in his way, making it incredibly difficult for the hook not to hit the doorway. Then Soon lays into his head, bursting him down incredibly low. His teammates do a bit more damage and he has to take a breather, setting up Soon to land an easy pulse bomb to remove the problem. Here on Anubis, Soon's gonna get into a battle against Harblue. And between the Discord orb and the burst of Tracer's pulse pistols, Harblue has to run away to take a breather. He gets a Zarya bubble as he peeks back out to grab the hook, but knowing the timing of the cooldown, as soon as Soon sees him, he knows he's gotta dart away and break line of sight from the Roadhog. Once the hook's down, he dips in again to deal some DPS, and when his clip's expended, he blinks backwards to dodge a possible right click. But notice he doesn't get greedy to chase after the Roadhog though. He takes the kill in front of him and he knows he has the man advantage, so there's no reason to just chase in at close range where Roadhog is lethal. He lets his teammate pick up the kill and they take the point. Here, playing against Harblue once again, Complexity takes the top left side on Nepal. A skirmish breaks out, and we're gonna get to see this from Harblue's perspective. He spams into the Rhine shield, and to keep himself safe, he backs up to reload. Blink and you'll miss it. Tracer zips right through the entire lineup to get into Complexity's spawn side to harass the Roadhog. This forces the attention of Complexity's main DPS and star player to be all tied up with Soon to no avail, allowing for a much more favorable fight for his teammates in the outside. Over and over again, he baits Harblue in to commit to the fight and then blinks away at a moment's notice, only shooting when he knows it's safe. Because his goal here is not to secure the kill quickly, but to deal as much free damage as possible. The longer he can poke in and out without dying himself, the better chance the rest of his team will have against the tank-heavy lineup, which completely lacks DPS with Harblue putting his attention elsewhere. With a man down, Complexity knows they have to back up, and Misfits takes the point. Here, Soon's on defense again, and is holding close positioning where his pulse pistols are lethal, and waits to strike. Once the enemy push comes in, he drops a pulse bomb in one of his favorite spots, right on the backside of the enemy Reinhardt's shield. This puts the Reinhardt in a terrible position, with no real good choice to make. Does Rein decide to drop his shield and run away from his team, so he doesn't blow them up with a pulse bomb, but then it would open them all up to the range damage from Misfits who do have their Reinhardt shield up. Here, what the Rein elects to do is to just eat it without trying to dodge, but it ends up blowing up his friendly Soldier 76 who had Tac Visor up and was looking to stay safe behind the Reinhardt shield. Pulse bombs can be pretty hard to hit, and although Soon is good enough to close the distance into melee range, which is typically required to land it on a squishy target, more often than not, he'll look to drop it on the enemy team's main tank, who typically is getting used to protect a squishy, and that allows the pulse bomb's blast radius to use the proximity of those characters against them, making it for Soon the best of both worlds. A nice big target for him to reliably hit, but also with the high likelihood of the splash also hitting a squishy target. Well, that's it for this first Pro Player Breakdown Advanced Guide. I hope you guys enjoyed this Pro Tracer breakdown, and you were able to pick some things up based on observing the Tracer God himself, Soon. I'll leave a link in the description to the VOD for DreamHack Winter if you're interested in catching up on these cool games. At the very least, I'd suggest that you watch Misfits as they develop their triple DPS playstyle over the course of the LAN until, of course, they win the grand final. I'll leave any of Soon's social media linked in the description as well, but also down there you can see a link to our Discord server that you can use to find teammates to pair up with on any platform at any skill rank. As well, if you like, you can follow the Your Overwatch Twitter, where you can get updates, stream announcements, see cool clips, and converse with us about the game. As well, check out our Twitch stream, where we live stream each and every day and do a variety of different things, play styles. We play a lot with fans. We do try hard rank grind six stacks and try our best to emulate the pro style of play. But we also do pro VOD reviews and user submitted gameplay coaching. So you want to set up email notifications so that you can know not only when we're streaming, but what type of stream we're doing that day. Check that out on Twitch, linked in the description below. And hey, if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel, hit the red button as we upload each and every day. That's been it for me. I've been Frito for Your Overwatch. I'll see you guys next time.